A big hello to all the wildlife lovers. EcoWild welcomes you to its yet another thrilling episode of Man and Animal coming together. Life as we know it has changed. And how? Today, we will going to show you an insight into the impact COVID-19 has inflicted upon ecology of wildlife. Then follow me to the Finda Chase National Park, Australia. Let's interview the wildlife here. Oh look, I spotted a kangaroo here.
Hi Mr. Roo, how are you?
I'm having a great time.
Oh come on. What's so great about this worldwide lockdown? So you are like enjoying man in captivity due to this viral pandemic?
Yeah, it's karma, you see. He loves keeping me and my fellow wildlife in cages. And now, this teeny weeny virus has caged him in his home itself.
Oh, you seem to be very unhappy with how humans have been treating wildlife so far. How do you feel they have troubled the wildlife?
See, God or even nature created humans with more intelligence so that he could maintain harmony with nature. But he has used his intelligence to exploit every trace of nature to fulfill and take care of his own needs only.
Really? Would you elaborate how?
Man is fascinated with our flesh, skin, fur, teeth, horns and bones. To satisfy his craving for leather goods, we are poached, at times killed outright. At times left to die a slow, painful death. Is that fair? Is our life so cheap? How can he derive pleasure in hunting us, hurting us and wearing our corpses with pride?
I agree that killing wildlife for food and fur is a selfish act.
Now, let me take you to India, a country with 21.67% forest land. Now, let me take you to Nagarhole National Park, a national park situated in India. Oh look, I spotted a tiger here.
Oh, it has been a long time since I saw any human being. Life has been very peaceful for a little while. Else, the safari jeeps and adventurous tourists were a menace to our life.
Menace? Why so?
Human being is getting more ambitious and less balanced. He is invading our habitats to expand his own establishments and even tapping into alternate sources of energy. The recent one being the nuclear energy. The nuclear test, when conducted, engulfed the entire biota in a vast area. Is man right in tapping the nuclear energy at the cost of our habitats?
You know, you are right. The energy of harmful radiation from the tar is killing the birds and bees.
You have built dams, flyovers, bridges and cities that are feeding on our habitat. How can man limit us to few zoos and natural parks? We are not exhibits to be viewed for recreation. Earth has sufficient space for man's need, but not his greed. How can man restrict our freedom?
Every being on this earth is indivisible when it comes to maintaining the ecological balance.
Ever since COVID-19, human activities have been brought to a halt.
Dear friends, through this interaction, we hope to invoke the humanity and fellow feeling that is vital if we are to coexist with the nature.